Namaste, welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Nowadays all of us know the importance of millets and how they are really considered to be a superfood for your health. So introducing you to another millet, this is known as little millet. See, this is what it looks like. The other names are, I think in Hindi it is called as kutki, samai in Tamil, Sama in Marathi, Samalu in Telugu, and various other languages you can look it up. So this is basically the little millet. Although name is little, its nutritional benefits are not little. It is a really very nutritious millet, which has got a very low glycemic index, so good for people with diabetes. It is good for weight loss also, also good for reducing your cholesterol levels. Very often we want to use these millets, but we don't know how to cook them. So today I will teach you how to cook this little millet and what are the different ways you can use it. So first of all, I have taken one measure of this. You can take any measure. One measure of this little millet, and what we have to do is we have to wash it thoroughly in plenty of water 2 or 3 times. This is because sometimes there might be some sand or dust on it. So 2 or 3 times wash it very well. Wash it very well till the water runs clear. Now after draining out all the water, add fresh water and soak it for at least 30 minutes. That is half an hour you soak this millet and keep it aside before cooking. It is 30 minutes now, we are ready to cook the millet. So just drain out the excess water. Always use a sieve like this so that you don't lose out any of the millet while draining it. Especially for those who are used to eating rice as their staple food and you want to change over to something more healthy, you can use this little millet. So for one measure of this little millet, I am using 4 measures of water. First, I am going to cook it like a plain rice and show you. So whenever you cook in a clay pot, first you add water to it before switching it on. So I am going to use in the proportion of 1:4. So 1 cup of little millet, 4 cups of water. When the water starts boiling, add this drained little millet to it. Now cover it, reduce the flame to minimum, that is sim, and then cook it. It should be done in about 10 minutes because we have already soaked it. The cooking time will be very much reduced. It is exactly 10 minutes now. Let's open it. See, all the water has been absorbed. At this stage, just switch it off, cover it and keep it aside. With this samai rice, you can either use it instead of your plain rice, have this samai rice with some dal and vegetable like your regular lunch. Or we can even make a delicious curd rice out of it. We'll just leave it aside for another 10 minutes now. See, this little millet is so versatile. We can even use it for a breakfast recipe. Let's make an upma with this. So here again, I've taken the same one measure of this, washed it 2 or 3 times and soaked it in water for 30 minutes. Now we'll just drain out the excess water. Add some mustard seeds, cumin seeds, a few curry leaves. Here I have 2 green chilies and a small piece of ginger. I'm adding 1 chopped onion. And whatever vegetables you have at home, you can include. First, saute the onion. We can add a pinch of turmeric powder to this. add salt. Next, I have taken little bit of cabbage, one carrot and a few green peas, frozen peas. So whatever you have, if you have some beans or capsicum also you can use. It will go well in this upma. Stir fry everything well together. Now add water to this. I am adding 2 and a half. And allow the vegetables to cook and the water also to come to a boil. See, the water is boiling now. Now just add this washed and drained little millet to it. Mix it well. Cover it and cook till done. See, it's just about 7 or 8 minutes now and our upma is done. All the water is absorbed. I switch it off. And for the final touches, I like to add some fresh grated coconut. These are all optional. You can serve it as it is, but these all enhance the taste. A little bit of lime juice and my all-time favorite roasted groundnuts and some freshly chopped coriander leaves. Just with the light hand, mix everything well together. See what a nutritious, colorful, tasty breakfast your little millet upma, which can be made at a very short notice. So this is also ready. Earlier we had cooked the little millet like a plain rice. See, after about 10 minutes is how it is. Now some of this I want to take it out and make it into a curd rice. You can just take out the required quantity, mash it lightly and allow it to cool to room temperature. The millet has cooled well. Just add a little bit of salt. Here I have some beaten curd. Mix the cooked millet with the beaten curd. Mix it well. See that there are no lumps. I'm adding a little extra curd because on cooling it will absorb more curd. So it's good if you have a little bit extra curd in it like this. Just take a little bit of oil. Add some mustard seeds, a few cumin seeds, a pinch of hing, green chili chopped, and a few curry leaves. Pour the tempering on top of the millet curd rice. So, using this nutritious little millet, we have seen how to cook little millet rice, which can be served instead of the regular white rice for lunch, as I have done in this thali. I have just served this little millet rice and some sabji or poriyal made with cabbage and carrot, dal, some vetta kolambu, and here I have used this curd rice, little millet curd rice, and some salad. See, when I cook this rice today, I have used 1:4 water for cooking the rice because we like our rice to be a little soft. But if you like it a more grainy texture, then you use only 1:3 water as it suits you. For example, when we made upma, I used only 1:2.5 because I didn't want it to become very mushy, but it should be a little grainy. So you just adjust the water content and you have a perfect nutritious meal ready. You can make so many other dishes using this. As I said, because of its low glycemic index, it's an excellent food for diabetics, very good for weight loss, very good for controlling your cholesterol, and also it has got a lot of fiber. But those with a thyroid problem, it is advised not to take too much of millets. Maybe occasionally you can have it just once in a way. But for all others and people of all age groups, this is an excellent meal. Thank you for watching the video. We'll meet again with another interesting video from Geeta's Kitchen. Please subscribe to Geeta's Kitchen and don't forget to tap the bell icon. Many of you tell me that you don't receive the subscriptions. Please do tap the bell icon and tap it on all so that you get the notifications for all my videos. Thank you.